Hello everyone, I welcome you on the third session of Marketing Management. Today we will continue with a term that is known as Marketing Myopia. When we talk about the simple word, simple phenomena, it is considered as a colored and crooked perception of the marketing and a short-sightedness about the businesses. Most of the time, it is possible, it happens with us that we are sitting in our drawing room or living room and projecting about our offices. My office will be such a multi-story building, number of cars is there, multiple type of businesses are there, and suddenly somebody come and knock us, come on, wake up, you are at your home rather your office. So this is what a colored and crude perception what we tended to have about the marketing. So we cannot make the projections by sitting in our drawing room or bedroom or our living room. We need to face the marketing situations, because if marketing myopia will be there, we are not going to focus exact scenario, exact conditions. So it is a kind of disease, it is a kind of error. So marketing need to be take proper protection with this job. Excession attention of the production or the product or selling aspects that the cost of the customer and his actual need creates this type of myopia. A myopia always leads a wrong or inadequate understanding of the market and hence failure to the marketplace. It even leads to a wrong or inadequate understanding of the very nature of the businesses in which the organization is properly engaged. Let's come to one of the interesting topic of marketing management, that how the marketing concept has been evolved. At the time of the Industrial Revolution, that is here in 1880 at England, the globally Industrial Revolution incurred lots of industrialization among the globe. Different countries are able to be developed more and more with their organizing capability, with their growth prospects, and with their even marketing abilities. So the concept has been evolved from the Industrial Revolution. At the moment, since Industrial Revolution to 1920, we followed the production era concept, where the assumption about the marketer, where the marketer's focus, he takes the assumptions about the product, that when the product will be more and more in the production house, the more production will be there, the more selling will get automatically. This was a negative phenomena. This was a misconception. Hence, this era would not get a desired success. Then after, in 1920, the marketer orientation has been shifted towards product specifications. Now marketer has started the considering the product as a better quality product. Marketer focuses about what product they have that is the superior product. This concept has been continued till 1922-1930, under this marketer started product focusing. Later on, in 1930, marketers increased their selling capabilities. Marketers increased their capabilities to enhance the forces, and this make marketers more sound. Still, in 1950, the concept of marketing concept has been emerged, where individual concept need to be recognized, and accordingly, the marketer started their processing first to identify the need of the customer, then to manufacture the product as per as need of the customer. So, leading towards social marketing era in the year 1990 to 2010, that means people are more conscious to serve society. People are more conscious to grouping homogeneous kind of the variables, where similar forces, similar type of requirements are come together to cater better manner, to cater better performances. And then in the 2010 onwards, we are in the customized marketing era, in which every individual customer are served, focused, recognized with their need. Then there are lots of variables who affect our marketing environment, who can affect our decisions. We need to understand
to those environments. Primarily, their basic objective is to understand that the forces affect the company's ability to serve the customers. How changes in the demographic and the economic environments affect marketing decision. It also identifies the major trends in the firms, the nature and the technological environments. It is required to know the key changes in the political and the cultural environments, understand how companies can react to the marketing environment. The key drivers aspect of marketing environment is micro environment and macro environment. Micro environment, the actors close to the companies, and the macro environment, larger society forces. The macro environment, departmental within the company and impact marketing planning. The macro environment, it uses to provide a supplier has to create and deliver customer value. It treats suppliers as a planning. In micro marketing, intermediaries also one of the key variables which need to help to sell, promote and distribute. Intermediaries can be many forms: resellers, physical distribution firms, marketing services agencies, and the financial intermediaries too. Customer, of course, is one of the major stakeholders. In market, we will have different types of the customer: individual consumer, business consumer, governmenter, reseller, maybe international customer. We need to take care about that. Successful companies provide better customer value than the competition. Size and industry position help to determine the competitive strategy. There are also factors in the macro environment, like the company, supplier, marketing intermediaries, customers, competitors, publics. These are the internal factors also. In macro, the factors which are not able to control, like government, media, financial, local, general, and the internal factors too. Citizens action group that you need to understand. What are the major macro variables? Demographic variables are there: economic, natural, technological, political, and the cultural. Let us see one by one. The macro, the key demographic trend, the world population growth. We need to understand. Now, our world population is about 6.2 billion, projected to reach 7.9 billion by 2025 with the changing growth. And demographic variable, US population consists of the 7 generational group. Baby boomers, Generation X, and Generation Y are their key groups. Distinct segments typically exist with these general generational groups. In key demographic trended, we need to understand about changing American households, geographic population shift, better educated, more white collar workforce, and increasing diversity. This is the best thing which we need to understand from the Americans too. In the economic environment, affect consumer purchasing power and spending patterns. US customer now spend carefully and desire greater value. The two types of national income: subsistence and industrial, that we need to understand. US income distributed in quick: upper class, middle class, working class, underclass. Rich getting richer, middle class wrinkles, underclass still poor. Consumer spending patterns are changing nowadays. We need to understand about the natural environment, which is also concerned for the natural environment has grown steady, increasing the importance of these trends, shortage of raw material, increasing pollutions, increased governmental interventions too. That many companies are using recycling to help protect natural resources, like McDonald's. Key technological trend. We need to understand about the new technology create new opportunities to marketers, but make old technology obsolete. The political environment include laws, governmental agencies, pressure groups, impact organizations, and their individuals. These trends include increased legislation to protect businesses as well as the consumers, changes in the governmental agencies, enforcement, increased emphasis on the ethical behavior and the social responsibilities too. Cause-related marketing is one of the methods to demonstrating social responsibility. Under this category, we also focusing on the corporate social responsibilities too. The cultural environment is composed of the institutions and the forces that affect the society's basic values, perception, preferences, and behaviors. It also affects or abstract from the core belief and the persistency, cultural value changes and shift more easily. Societal values are expected to people's view, their themselves, others, organizations, society, maybe nature, of course, still universe also. How we need to respond to the marketing environment, that actually need to understand very carefully. That is in reactive mode, the passive acceptance and adaptation. Companies design a strategy that avoid threats and capitalize upon the opportunities. Proactive environmental management used to lobbyists, PR, advertorials, lawsuits, complaints, and contractual agreement to influence environmental forces. So we have two different options. Either we need to go with the proactive or we need to go with the reactive. If we are in reactive, we need to passive acceptance and adaptation. And proactive, we need to manage our environment effectively. Today, we understand about these forces and definitely we learned many things. If you like our video, if you like our sessions, please do like button, share and subscribe our YouTube channel to always stay updated, always stay connected. Till now, take care. Thank you very much. If you have any query, you can write in our comment box also. Thank you very much.